So Docker is an application that simplifies the process of managing applications into containers. And containers let you run your own applications in resource-isolated processes. So they're similar to virtual machines, but the thing is that containers are more portable, they're more user-friendly, and they're more depending on the host operating system than anything else. And they use a lot less resources. So in this video, I'm going to show you how we can use Docker for cybersecurity. So we're going to be installing Docker, then we're going to do an installation of Docker Compose. And then afterward, I'm going to show you how to install a few cybersecurity tools, and it's going to be pretty, pretty cool. All right, so let's get started. So this is my Proxmox. This is my actual virtualizer. And I have a Ubuntu 22.04 here running in my virtualizer. So I'm going to launch my terminal in here, and I'm going to SSH into this machine. And there you go. So this is Ubuntu. The first thing that I need to do, obviously, is going to be doing an update. I'm going to run sudo update apt update y, and let's do an update. Perfect. I have 21 packages. I just installed this server, so I have a lot of stuff probably that I need to upgrade. So let's see what we have. Yeah, and most of it is from the main distribution of Ubuntu. So let's do an update. So sudo apt upgrade, and then out to remove, and I'm gonna put y just so it doesn't ask me any questions and goes ahead with it. Perfect. So this is gonna take a little bit of time just because there's so many applications and so many libraries that are being updated right now. All right, perfect. So we are done. The next thing is we want to make sure that this Docker is part of our distro sources. We're going to install a few prerequisites: apt transport, https, ca certificates, curl. We're going to need curl as well, and software properties commons. So I'm going to run this, say yes. Perfect. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to add the key, so the gpg key of the official Docker repository into our system. And to do that, then we just gotta curl this. So all of this stuff is gonna be below on the link, so you can see what we need to do. So I'm going to put the GPG key into my user share keyrings. So that's where you hold all your keys from different repositories. So we do that. And now let's add Docker to our APT or package management, right? So in this case, what we're doing is we're adding the package right into with the sign. So here you can see the signature, user share keyring, and then the signature, download from Ubuntu, and then add it to our source list in here. And then all we have to do here now is just an update of our distro. So we do that, and you'll see that now Docker is going to be part of our distro. We do also an app cache policy Docker CE. So we're making sure in here that we're installing from Ubuntu Jammy. So this is important in here. So that's why I'm doing an apt cache policy Docker CE, right? So installing from Jammy, that's what we want to do. And now let's just install Docker. So there you go. So sudo apt install Docker CE, say yes. Now this is going to take a little bit of time. Perfect. So just click enter, and now we have Docker install. Now, in order for us to be able to see if we have or Docker is running, we just do a systemctl, right? So systemctl status Docker, and you can see that it's running now. And we're also going to make it part of our startup. So if whenever the computer shuts off and then you turn it on again, then Docker is going to start as well. So enable Docker like that. Perfect. So now we have Docker installed. So the only thing about Docker, so if I do, for example, Docker PS, permission deny. So every time I have to use Docker, I have to do sudo, right? So sudo docker ps, for example, you need to use sudo in order to launch or do any commands with Docker. So by default, the Docker command can only be run with the root user. If you want to avoid typing sudo whenever you run the Docker command, we have to add our username to the Docker group, right? So in order to do that, so then what we do is, this is the command. So sudo user mod minus ag docker, and then I can put here my name. Then there you go. So I just added it. And then if I do sudo su, for example, right? And then I just do sudo dan. So I'm going back and I check my groups. So groups, then I'll see that it's added to Docker. So now when I do, for example, docker ps, then I don't have to type in sudo. That's very important, very convenient, right? For using Docker. Using Docker consists of passing a chain of options and commands before Docker. So it's usually like this, right? So you enter Docker, right? At the beginning, because it's a CLI, and then option, then a command, and then an argument. That's basically how Docker works and how pretty much every other CLI would work as well. So if I just type in Docker, then I'll see all the information about Docker in terms of how to use it, right? So you can run, execute, ps, build, pull, push, image, and so on. I can also do Docker help or Docker info. So Docker help, so dash dash help, like that. And then it's exactly the same thing. And if I type in Docker version, for example, then it gives me the version of Docker. In this case, I'm using 24.0.6. I can also do Docker version like that, right? So this is a kind of like a quick and dirty way of getting the Docker version, right? So now if you want help with different subcommands, for example, you can do a, let's say, Docker ps and then help. So this is very convenient because it only gives you the help on the Docker ps. So if I type in, for example, Docker build help, then it gives me just the information about how to build and what commands I can pass when I'm doing build, right? So it doesn't give you the whole entire help menu, but it does give you information just about what you're looking for. All right, let's run a few images now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to install the typical hello world. So it is Docker, there you go, run hello world, right? So I'm going to do this, there you go. So you can see hello from Docker in here, which is fantastic. So you can see that Docker is basically working right now. So if I do, for example, Docker ps, and I'll show you how to do commands later on, Docker ps all, for example, then you'll see that it is right there. Let's just delete it. This is just junk, right? So I'm going to remove it. That is Docker rm remove. So now if you do it again, it's gone, right? So let's look for Kali Linux, right? So let's look for Kali Linux. I'm going to do a Docker search Kali. And then it gives me a whole bunch of Kali, different Kali distros that I can use from different people, I guess, or different sources. But here's the official Kali Linux Docker image, right? So if I go into Kali Docker, then here it is, right? So this is the Docker image for Kali. You can see here the information inside of the Kali website. So let's go back here and let's do it again. And this is what we want to pull, right? So we're going to be pulling Kali distro and copy, then Docker pull Kali Linux / Kali rolling. Perfect. Okay, so now if I do Docker images, then you'll see that I have these two images. I did delete the container for Hello World, but I can actually remove the image as well. So let's do that. So in order to do that, just copy this and say Docker RMI for remove image, and it is gone. So now if I look for the images, all I see is this image in here, which is pretty cool. So now let's get it into Kali, right? So this is going to be super easy for you. So Docker run, and then you put IT for, I guess, interactive, and then type in Kali or this name, the repository or whatever the image name is. Oh, let me just copy it here. And look at this. Now we do have Kali. I'm actually inside of the Kali image. This is a container that is Kali Linux, and I'm inside of the container right now. So how cool is this? So in here, I'm going to do apt update. Why? Right. So we're updating the Kali Linux distro. That's so cool. And now I'm going to do an upgrade. So apt upgrade, and I say yes, out to remove, and let's just upgrade Kali. All right. So let's see this. So I'm going to install. So apt install NeoFetch. Perfect. Beautiful. Say yes. I guess let's do an entire upgrade as well. I don't know what happened in there, but it's do an entire upgrade. So let's go back to see what's going on in here. I'd remove. Well, it's a lot of information. Perfect. So we did the upgrade, and now I'm going to install NeoFetch. So apt install NeoFetch, right? Install NeoFetch. There you go. Perfect. Now NeoFetch. And there it is. So Kali Linux. And look at this. There it has only 253. So it's a very lean version of Kali. And let's see if Nmap is installed. Nmap version. Nope, it's not installed. So I have to install it. So apt install Nmap. Sorry about that. There you go. Okay. Perfect. Now Nmap version. And there it is. Version 7.94. So you can see how I was able to install Kali Linux in here, and I can install any other tools that you want, right? So let's get out of this container. I'm going to type in exit to get out, and there you go. So I'm back in my distro here. Let's do a few commands so we can manage Docker, right? So the first one is, it's the easiest one, which is ps. To view the active Docker containers, all you have to type in is just Docker. So everything, all the time, you start with Docker PS, and there's no active containers. Nothing is running right now. If I type in Docker PS A, A stands for all, then I can see the containers that I have, which are not running. You can see that it exited. So the status of the Docker container is exited 46 seconds ago. So that's when I killed. It's so funny. It says Kind Torvalds. That's the name of the container. Kind Torvalds. So that's when I exited that. If I do Docker PSL, that will be the latest. So that's the latest Docker container that I have installed, right? So we can do other commands, like for example, start. So let's start this guy. So the container ID, you always focus on the container ID. So I'm going to do a Docker start the ID, and then it started. So if I do a Docker PS now, then you see that it's running. Right? So it's running. I can also use the name to stop or to run the containers. So I can say, okay, so this is the name of the container, Kind Torvalds. I'm going to say Docker stop and then Kind Torvalds. There you go. So now if I do Docker, see that it's not there. Now, if I want to remove it, I can just type in RM. I can type in the name, or I can type in also the container ID, and it will remove it. So now if I type in this and I click OK, and I do Docker PS all, you'll see that is gone. This is really cool. I can run all kinds of containers. So in the next episode, in the next video, I'm going to show you how to use Docker Compose to make your life so much easier. And the thing about Docker Compose, it's when you have different containers. So let's say Kali Linux is only one container, one image. But if you need to combine, let's say you have an image that is MySQL, and then you have another image that is Apache, and then you have another image that does something else, then you want to combine them, then you use Docker Compose for doing that type of stuff. So we're going to install Docker Compose, and then I'll show you how to use it and install OpenBAS as well as Wazoo maybe, and some other applications for cybersecurity. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.